Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Raghuram. I'm from Ujaz. And I just wanted to give a brief, very brief introduction to my company, considering the fact that this is the first post-lunch session. And most importantly, I wanted to cover a very important aspect which affects solar companies, that is of net metering, that I'll take on at the end of the presentation. So for the next 3 minutes, very briefly, I would like to introduce my company to you. We started our solar journey on 2012 with the first 21 megawatt plant in Rajgarh, MP. And as on date, we have installed nearly 269 megawatts as on date in the last 5 years. And our operations extend from Uttarakhand in the north to Assam in the east and Andamans in the south. We have very strong financials and you know, we are in the business for the long run. We were the first, some of our achievements, we were the first company to install a megawatt level solar plant in MP. And the first solar plant to operate under REC mechanism in the country. We were the first to install a commercially owned rooftop with the bi-directional metering. And also we were the first to install a canal bank solar project in Bengal. Some of the accolades that we have received, needless to say, we have a number of them. Prominent amongst them being the ones with from Business World and Forbes Asia, where we have been rated as the best amongst the 200 under billion companies. We are listed in the National Stock Exchange and the Bombay Stock Exchange as well with a CRISIL SP1A rating. These are the major divisions in our company, solar parks, which we started off in 2012. 2014, we started the rooftop divisions, that is the commercial side. EPC the next year, and very recently, last year in Feb, we started the domestic segment as well. I'll just skip this. With the solar parks, we have had a very extensive experience, and our main focus in these parks being the O&M side. We have a very strong O&M team, and you can see the average CUF in the order of 19, more than 19. Some of the major ones being Rajgarh, Barod, recently in Diu, Aligarh Muslim University. The EPC as well, we have had a very good CUF of more than 17. The recent installations, the major projects being with Hindustan Aeronautics. This is the inauguration of this project, and the photo at the left corner is the project installation. As far as rooftop segment is concerned, this is one of the key focus areas for Ujaz Energy. And by the end of this financial year, we are likely to exceed 26 megawatts in installation in rooftops. This includes both commercial as well as residential. With the home segment, though we aim to have a standardized kit, but there are some instances like the one at the right, that is a customized solution. So based on the requirement, though it's more economical for us to go in for a standardized kit, in case the customer requirement is there, we do the customized construction as well. These are some of the photographs of the rooftops installations that we have done. This is the breakup of the business that we have had, with the majority being with the universities, schools and colleges, and the government buildings. Significant business has come from BSNL and other PSUs like MOIL and Indian Oil. As far as the home segment is concerned, as on 5th January, we have had 961 installations, These are 961 dwellings. So in a week or so, this figure is going to cross 1,000 houses. So that's a achievement for us. This is some of the fact sheets for the major installations that we have done, 200 kilowatt in Noida. Like I said earlier, our focus area is basically very strong O&M support. So major part of our employee strength is in O&M. So we aim to ensure that post installation we deliver what we have promised prior to installation. So this is a snapshot of one of the customers after net metering. This was done last year. This is the electricity bill, and we still are managing the zero billing. So this is we take this as one of our achievements. O&M, like I mentioned, focus area for us, and we use all the latest technology that is available in terms of thermal imaging and all kinds of proactive methods to resolve problems. And the list goes on. Some of our key customers: Indian Oil, NTPC, BSNL being major customers for us. I would like to show you some more slides. I thought they would be possible.
I have time. I'll just take a minute.
So this is the issue that I wanted to flag today. This is the process involved in getting a net metering done. So this process varies from state to state, and most complicated and time consuming being Madhya Pradesh. And this is the approximate amount of days which each step in the process takes. So if you analyze this data, the connecting thing, the common factor in all these is wherever the documents are going to the DISCOM official for vetting or signature, there's a significant amount of delay. Recently, there was a letter circulated by MNRE asking for suggestions from the stakeholders in what the process should be as far as this entire right from NOC to subsidy, claiming subsidy is concerned. So in our view, system being followed by Gujarat, GEDA, we find it to be the most efficient as far as the process online is concerned. Though there is still delay in Gujarat as well as far as subsidy and net metering is concerned, but however, the system is quite streamlined. The only suggestion being that Gujarat doesn't give the flexibility to the companies to buy their own net meter in case the DISCOM is not able to provide it in time. So in case they provide us with this leeway, then I think it would actually benefit the customers to a great extent, because we would be able to then finish the installation and ensure the net metering is also done and charge the solar plant of the customers within a week, maximum of 1 week's time. Right now, I think it takes around a month to month and a half in the best case scenario. So this is food for thought, and I would request all people here to just, in case you're able to voice your opinion on this issue at the appropriate forum. Thank you.